Sawadee, kuzu zangpo. Welcome back to Adventures in Language. I'm your guide, Kaitlyn. In this video, we're talking about fluency. Are you fluent in your second language? How do you know? We'll talk about what it means to be fluent and why that might look a little different for everyone. Not yet as fluent as you want to be? Check out our video on the three questions you can ask yourself to reflect on what might be holding up your own quest for fluency. Let me start by telling you a little story. During my junior year of college, I spent the fall semester in France. It was a dream come true. But coming from a large family with lots of aunts, uncles, and cousins, it was a big deal to miss celebrating Thanksgiving with them. I called home that day, and as the phone was passed around, I fielded the question, "So, are you fluent in French yet?" at least a dozen times. And each time, I felt more uncomfortable and less certain about my response. Finally, a voice on the other end of the line asked, "So, you're not really fluent yet, are you?" That voice belonged to my mom's sister, Pat. She's a high school Spanish teacher who'd spent time abroad and inspired me to do the same on my own language learning journey. Now, it wasn't that she lacked faith in my language abilities, but rather that she could really empathize with me. As a highly proficient second language speaker, my Aunt Pat's definition of fluency was much different from that of my other, mostly monolingual family members. In my own experience as a language learner, language teacher, and language scientist, I've noticed that the concept of fluency in a second language can be highly ambiguous. For most people, being fluent is synonymous with having high proficiency, that is, being able to speak another language well. But definitions of fluent range from getting by in a language to speaking almost as well as a native speaker. Dictionaries really don't do much to clear things up and instead provide fairly vague definitions, like Merriam-Webster's capable of using a language easily and accurately. But how easily? How accurately? And can you be fluent without being all that accurate? Let's take a look at what the fluency experts have to say. The American Council on the Teaching of Foreign Languages, commonly known as ACTFL, considers a language learner to have superior spoken proficiency when they can speak with ease, fluency, and accuracy. The Common European Framework of Reference, or CEFR, assesses spoken language based on five aspects of language use, which include both fluency and accuracy. In order to reach the highest CEFR level, speakers need to be able to navigate a conversation in another language with ease. So we can see that according to ACTFL and CEFR, which are two widely used guidelines for language proficiency standards, fluency is just one component of proficiency, distinct from ease and accuracy. But what is it that sets fluency apart from these other aspects of spoken proficiency? Second language researchers pay attention to very specific aspects of spoken language when measuring fluency. In particular, they analyze talking speed in relation to pauses, hesitations, repetitions, and self-corrections. In other words, how quickly can you speak and what trips you up? Are you pausing frequently to search for words? Are you hesitating while you try to conjugate a verb correctly? Do you correct yourself often? Taken together, these measurements seem to assess how well speech rolls off the tongue, which makes sense given that the word fluent derives from the Latin fluere, meaning to flow. Now let's talk for a second about what fluency is not. There are some aspects of spoken proficiency that are not usually considered when assessing fluency. These include accuracy, which is the amount of errors or lack thereof in speech, coherence or connecting ideas in speech, and the ability to use a wide range of idiomatic expressions, which means slang and culture-specific phrases. Now, while these factors could lead to more hesitations and self-corrections, which are part of fluency, this isn't necessarily enough to overshadow talking speed. This is something that I witnessed firsthand when I first started learning Spanish. I was able to travel to Argentina with my cousin, who'd been studying Spanish for years and was teaching in Chile at the time. I painstakingly and often unsuccessfully labored over performing perfect sentences in Spanish, while she was able to speak a mile a minute. Now, was her Spanish absolutely perfect? No. It was peppered with English filler words like so, She never addressed strangers formally, to the horror of her mother, the Spanish teacher. And she'd do things like ask for a bomb, una bomba, instead of a straw, una bombilla, which made for some interesting interactions, to say the least. But she spoke with such ease and confidence that her Spanish, while not always perfect, was unquestionably fluent. So what does this tell us? Well, even some of the most fluent speakers make mistakes. Unsurprisingly, though, studies show that proficiency and fluency are highly correlated. In other words, the most fluent speakers are usually the most proficient and therefore make the fewest errors. So what does this mean for you as a language learner? It may seem obvious that higher proficiency can lead to higher fluency. After all, if you have a better vocabulary, a stronger grasp on grammar, and a good command of local expressions, it should be easier to put a sentence together. But in turn, fluency can actually help you achieve higher proficiency. How? Here are some tips. Try singing along when you listen to music in another language. Read out loud. Practice talking in social contexts and about topics that are familiar to you. It's much easier to speak freely in a second language when you feel comfortable and your inhibitions are down. For example, I tend to practice by talking about my family because it's a topic that I care a lot about, and I found that it's one of the easier ones to access in a foreign language. If you use a language app, you can even explore and practice with new sentences in the privacy of your own home. For example, with Mango, you can read and listen to authentic sentences covering a wide range of topics and grammatical structures and practice saying them out loud. This is a great way to build both fluency and proficiency. It may be hard at first, but the more you practice putting sounds together, the more speaking will become automatic for your brain and vocal muscles, and forming complex sentences will become second nature. And finally, don't get too hung up on being perfect. Sometimes the path to fluency is about being okay with making mistakes. If you like this video and you want to stay tuned for more videos about the science behind language learning, make sure you subscribe to our channel. If there's a topic that you want to learn more about, tell us about it in the comments. Be sure to check out the description for this video for some free materials on second language fluency, including a fun interactive quiz on what fluency is and isn't. Thanks for watching. Sawasdee. Yasi mai.